we are live. We are live. I do apologize. How's it going, guys? Thanks for joining us on our first ever stream. Appreciate you being here. And I hope you're enjoying VP. I'm sorry, I was just closing a few things there. So I'm in the preview server. I've been in here for a little while at the moment. I've been here for about an hour and a half at the moment. I messed around with a few bits, trying to make myself ready. Now, I'm under the impression that to get the new hole in your base, you have to go out and hit a world map target. Lucy, can you just check the Twitter, which I'm working with and stuff?
Yeah.
Thank you. That is a wonderful Lucy from the Forsaken Council. Yeah, so it should be live now. I'm hitting the target now. I didn't have that pop-up before. I'll try and get Twitch up at the side of me so I can see the chat, because at the moment I don't know if I'm working or not working.
You can't see the video anymore.
What I'll do is I'll leave that on auto.
It says you're live, right?
I just hope I'm working, guys. You guys can hear me okay. I'm just going to double check that. And with a little bit of luck, we are working. I'll find out. I don't know what the hell's going on. There we go. So I've got the chat up now to the side of me as well, so I can see you guys. Yeah, let's rock and roll. Let's see what we can do. So as far as from what Doomrush has said, all you need to do is like hit these once, and then bugger off again. Like do minimal damage. God, it's been a while since I've seen one of these. These are the old ones, aren't they? I miss these ones. Punisher with D10 work okay. Okay, well what we're going to do is we're going to get this hole. We're going to get the hole one. Hi EU666. We're going to get the hole one, get the hole built, and then we're going to go out and test out some of these targets as well, which should be good. Excuse me, guys. So anyway, how are you all? How did you all enjoy the first show, for those that caught it? It wasn't a bad show, was it? Told you I wouldn't do a terrible show. and this is the first stream. For anyone that does miss a stream, this video will be going up onto YouTube after the stream's finished. God, I used to love doing this with Kodiaks back in the day. This was the fleet. Hopefully that should be it. I may as well just kill it while I'm here. It'd be faster to kill it than it will be to drive off and retreat. Let me close the chat there as well. So, yeah. Here we are at the preview. With a little bit of luck, it will go smoothly. I was in a preview a little bit earlier, but Kicksite, they didn't want anyone to preview, to stream the preview until it went public. So I had to obey the rules there, and much respect to Kicksite for allowing me and the public such a, you know, the ability to even come in this preview. Makes some difference being able to test stuff out, you know? yeah, Wim, I put that tag on there on purpose to, just so everyone knew I was here to say hello, you know? And good to see you in the chat, Erwin. I do apologise for the coughing. I have had man flu for about 3-4 weeks now, off and on. It just will not go away. The second it goes away, and then it comes back tougher, and then it goes away, and then it comes back tougher, and it's just wearing me down now. Right, with a little bit of luck, that's give us the gold. Here we go. There's the cannon. And with a little bit of luck, we've got the fleet too. I hope we've got the bloody fleet too. Let's go and have a look. Say commission prizes. No! Oh my god, I got a tier 3? I know, I got it in tier 1. Holy Jesus. So, coaxial, I heard that the preview is crap. The coaxial is overpowered. Well, let's take a look.
Yes, I agree.
Let's take a look at it. So, we're going to go to the shipyard. As you can see, I've probably already dipped into this gold that Kickstarter gave us to use near quite considerably. But anyway, let's have a look. Shipyard. Select hull. Blueprint tech. I think I can already see it. I wonder what's down here, though. Some interesting ships. Some ships I've never seen before. Anyway, let's forget that. Right, Centurion. So off the bat, armor points 6,993. That's impressive. That's very impressive base armor stats. Ballistic reload plus 40%, ballistic range plus 40%, ballistic damage plus 55%. Evade bonus 30%, ballistic defense 30%, radioactive defense 50%, seize deflection 475, which is pretty decent. Shame it doesn't have any assault deflection. Combat speed 18, already ridiculously fast. Turn speed 13, struggles on the turn speed a little. Cargo's very good at 5 and a quarter million, but it's a little bit less than that. Total repair time is 1 hour and 33 minutes. Fire field resistance plus 75%. That's pretty decent. I think that's the highest in the game of any known hull. I think only I think there's some fleets that have a 50% built in. Field of effect friendly. This is the interesting one that everyone was talking about. It has a field of effect that operates to any ships in its friendly field. Its range is only 20, which is equivalent to one land tile. So your fleet's going to have to be stacked for this to work. And it reduces splash. It's a splash damage reduction of 20%, and it affects all ships in any state. Okay? So let's have a look. I mean, that's some pretty impressive stats. Let's take a look at the gun now, and let's have a look at maybe how we'd armor this thing. There it is there. It looks very old. Kind of got like this oldie kind of look to it, but let's check out the stats on it first, if we can. I don't know if it would be easier to do that in the blueprint lab as opposed to it would be here. Let's do it in the blueprint lab so we can really crunch this thing up a little bit, and then we'll look at building it. Particle accelerator. So this is the new cannon everyone's been talking about. I believe that the build time, I'm not sure if that build time is accurate. It was in the last preview server with the Citadel Dark War, but it may change. Preview servers is always subject to change. One thing I can tell you is nothing changed in the last preview server to the raid. Okay, so the particle accelerator cannon is Forsaken, weapon type cannon, damage type ballistic, weight's pretty low at 285 tons. It adds an additional 200 armor points, which is always great. Splash of 6, range of 50, damage of 200, building damage 1,350. Reload time 3 seconds, accuracy 80. Repair duration is 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So already you can see that this thing is built for buildings. It's almost going to be useless against ships, especially Punishers. Like, if you think about siege assault deflection on a Punisher of 500 and this thing only does damage of 200, then you're going to get minimum damage against any kind of ship that has deflection, assault deflection. So it's a base hitting weapon or hitting base targets in the game, like Draconian bases and stuff. This is the interesting part that a lot of us don't know about, or a bit unsure about how this works. It's called a secondary weapon particle blast. It's a secondary ability, like a bonus ability. You have a 0.3% chance for this to go. That's like 1 in 300 to give you a statistic. It's actually more than that, but that's a rough estimate. It's literally 1 in 300 shots have a chance to do this. Perhaps that increases with critical hit chance. I don't know. I don't know if that would affect that. I would imagine it's a different stat entirely. But the trigger cooldown is 10 seconds. Well, to be honest, if you're going to get 300 shots off, you might need 10 seconds anyway. The splash is 40. The spread is 200. The range is 50, the damage is 2,000, the building damage, whoa, 113,460. And the weapon is going to be cannon and ballistic. So basically, for every 300 shots, these things turn into something ridiculous that do 120k damage and have a splash of 40, which is equivalent to 2 land tiles. That is absolutely ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. I've never seen a stat like that in my life. I mean, we do know that in a Drake Uranium basis, there is turrets that have, like, what, like the main, the Mega Drake turret in there, I believe, has something like 1 million armor points. So, you know, I can see it being warranted, but, I mean, if you had this on a fleet that was hitting a player's base, and it had that splash of 40, which is equivalent to 2 lanterns, you would take out someone's entire center island with one shot. One shot. Someone's entire center island. That's a statistic for you. Unreal. Right, let's get to building the damn thing, I guess. I'm wondering if how this is going to work out. Right. It's a ballistic hole. So we're going to go straight into the deep end with the Reaver range increaser, because it's the best one on the market. Do we need auto reloaders for this? I don't know. Its range is going to go up quite significantly on this. Let's do a calculation. So it has a range of 50, and I'm getting a ballistic range boost of 90%. 10% of 50 is 5, so times that by 9 is 45. That takes the range of this cannon up to 95. 95, guys. So that's the highest range in the game, is it? I believe. Maybe other cannons got that range. I'm not sure, but it's certainly not below. So 95 is impressive. Let's shove some speed on it. Let's shove some armor on it. Maybe we'll just fire in with a heavy plate, and why not, eh? Why not? Let's get on some resistance to stun, because I'm not sure if there's going to be stun in these bases. So that's kind of a general layout. I guess the next slot is optional, but you know what? I'm going to be a bit cheeky, and I'm going to shove this on. Siege battery. I'm going to boost this hole's defensive stats up while also boosting its turret defense. And the reason I'm doing that is because we're going in to fight some Drake mines with these. So let's. I think that would probably run quite well. At least we can change it to auto loaders afterwards if we feel the need to. But I'm probably going to rank this hole while we're here as well.
Siege battery.
Sorry.
Siege battery says
when. That is siege battery. Yeah, siege battery. I'm going to give it a whirl, because we're going in against these Drake bases. I don't know what's in there. So, yeah, and boosting their turret defense might give them a bit of a longer life. So, until I see these bases, what we'll do on this stream, because we've got 2 hours, is we'll try a couple of different tactics with these holes. We'll try a couple of different builds. We'll start off with a new tech, maybe adjust them a little bit. And then we'll fire into the older tech as well. And maybe we'll try them with, say, railguns and just see how they run like that as well. So we'll try a couple of different builds. Okay, URF, THE, how's it going, Steve? Mines have a lot of radioactive damage. Do they, Steve, can you confirm if, do they have any stun? Do they have any stun damage? Do you need stun resistance? No, I'm asking, because Steve's saying they have a lot of radioactive damage.
Yeah, I just hit one like 10 minutes ago.
Okay. Well, where is its radioactive defense stuff?
They have like frosties and stuff on them.
50%, okay. All right, Steve, I'm going to check them out. I'll run with a build and then we'll see how we go.
He says, over the top, Wendy.
Over the top, Wendy.
I got you. Your stream and that, so.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Let's switch from stun to... On that, we'll switch to reflective coating. Cheers for the advice, Steve. We'll try that. That brings our radioactive defense up to 63%, which is not a huge boost. Our evade's already fairly decent, so I'm quite happy to run with D5M, but what I might do is swap out a D5M for a D5R, taking our radioactive defense up to 69%. Not a fast improvement, to be fair, but... Let's go with it. Penetrative defense, ballistic defense, explosive defense is still quite low. I would like it. If I had some D5X, I'd be putting some D5X on here. I'll be getting that when that comes out next week after the raid. Okay, I'm happy to run with that. Let's see how many cannons we can squeeze on there before it gets too heavy. I wonder if I can just change that to cannons and make my life quicker. This is getting heavy fast. I wonder if anyone, Steve, if you can confirm a glacial turret. They have a glacial turret in there. Mm-hmm. Fuck's sake.
They have Wendigos too.
Mm, Steve said an over-the-top Wendigo, i.e. the new glacial turret.
I hit a 70, and it was extremely hard.
To be honest, guys, as well, one thing I'm noticing here is that is a low build cost. I don't know if you can see that, but 17 days and 21 hours for a fully armoured, fully weaponised, and fully specialised fleet. That's low. I would say that's low. Right, anyway, let's coin up. Let's use some of my hard-earned cash there on this. Some of that hard-earned cash of mine.
When
you
sent me pictures of them, do you
want
to see them?
No, it's okay. Well, I appreciate you sending the pictures, Wim. What we'll do is, maybe I'll get a picture up after, but I just want to get in there and actually have a look. So, let's see how we go. So, this fleet is already going to be a bit... I'll tell you what we'll do is we'll disassemble this Drake U-base fleet and we'll shove in these because this will boost their ballistic reload and their ballistic defense. So that's quite a sneaky move on my part. Yes, yeah, pat on the back, I know. And we'll rank them up a little bit as well. come on. Fuck's sake.
That's fair.
Gain rank instantly. My man. Right, we'll just leave them there for now. A star. No, we can't leave them as a star, can we?
Built them.
Yeah, I've built four, but I've spent so much gold already before I even started streaming.
I spent 30k in like 10 minutes.
Yeah, I was trying out a few things, guys, before the stream started, and I spent a little bit of gold in here. I must admit, I spent 30,000 gold in about 25 minutes. So I apologise about that. I would suggest leaving for single ship. I'm playing a caravan. This time, right? Okay, I got you, Steve. Okay. Let me go in, take a beating, and come up with a plan B. I think the best way for me to learn on that is to take a hit. I always want to learn when I get beaten, which happens quite a lot. More often than I like to admit.
Liam, can you try some...
Well, I'm just getting this fleet ranked. I know, guys...
NATO's in. He's given coordinates 1933. He just built a fleet.
Oh, Renato's in the chat there?
No, he's in our chat on Facebook.
Okay.
1933
supports. So, we do actually have a couple of other... admins from our group in. I don't know how they got in, but we do have Renato who's in there. So we're gonna go and check out a couple of hits from him while we're streaming as well, which is great. Yeah, sorry guys that you're sat there watching me rank. You know, I do apologise, but I mean, if we're going to test these out, let's do it properly. You know what I mean? Let's really test this out. I think we'll also test out hitting these new mines with traditional fleets too. But I think since Kixai made the point of saying that these ships are they're designed for these bases, then I for these new mines, and I guess it's only right that we try out these holes in them. God, I could never imagine doing this in the real game. I would cry.
You have went through that gold so quickly.
I'm sure it will be okay. Kixai can send me the bill. I'm sure it'll be fine. Right. Let's try them out, guys. Yeah, let's shove. I think we've got some ballistic crews in here somewhere. Okay, I've no crews now. That's cool. That's let's just try and fight a crew then. You know. Right. Let's start off for the purpose of the stream. We will try them on a low level to a mid level, and then we'll go in and get crucified in a high level because, you know. We want to test them all out. So, yeah, let's be wimps first and go in thinking we're heroes and we'll die later. Oh, it looks like someone wanted to kill me there. Surprise, surprise. It is like the real game. Right, Mr. Number One. You turn around. The rest of you follow me. Right, let's have a look at these. They look pretty interesting, actually, don't they? Could see
Well, they look cool.
Yeah, the problem is I need this bugger to stop moving.
Why is Gannon in there?
He's boosting their ballistic reload and their ballistic defense, which is probably not required in these bases, in all fairness. So that's them at legendary rank with an Amiga Behemoth boosting their reload further. And you can see that it's kind of a continuous stream, so that's a pretty decent reload on these new targets. One thing I'm noticing here is I've yet to see a frostbite unless I'm not looking right, which would suggest to me. Ah, okay. I just seen some little rings appear there. Maybe that was them stopping the splash. That would suggest to me that. The Aegis would be a good hole in there. If they don't have frostbites in them, then we're kind of laughing because that means we can bring in a Harlock Aegis to basically make the Wendigos not a thing. So yeah, we can try that.
They're awesome.
What these?
Yeah.
You think the holes are awesome, Lucy?
Yeah.
That is Arbiter Lucy in the background there. Not Arbiter. Sorry, Counselor. Counselor. I need a fucking counselor, excuse my French. Right, yeah.
Still got it in your brain.
Still got it, yeah.
I think they're awesome.
They look pretty good. I mean, I don't know if necessarily this would be the build path I would take them. Would be the exact build time I would take them, but I don't think it's too far off. I don't think it's too far off. I think if I was going to build them for my own perspective as a player, I probably wouldn't tailor them just to be doing these bases. I would probably put like a set on them that I could hit player bases with too. You know, so I probably wouldn't put the radioactive. I'd probably put stun resistance as my evade upgrade. Whoa. Did anyone just see that blue beam come out of my ship?
Yeah, I've seen it a few times, Liam.
Because that was intense.
That was awesome. That's quite sexual.
It was very sexual, actually.
It was, wasn't it?
Yeah.
People think we're such freaks.
People think we're freaks, but we kind of are. Because just remember, Lucy, what you said in the live show. God.
You get smashed every day.
Yeah. Do you see that? Yeah, do you see that blue beam, Wim? That was just... That was something else, wasn't it? And that's that does 110,000 damage. And I don't know if that calculates in... I don't know if that calculates in the ballistic boost in damage, because if it doesn't, I think these things have, what, a 40% ballistic boost in damage? So if it doesn't, then we could be looking at a much higher damage. I mean, 40% on top of 100k could take it well past 150k, you know, so yeah, and there's a potential that that's even bigger, and it does 40 splash win, yeah. 40 splash, so that's equivalent to 2 land tiles for anyone that wants a kind of a brain. But this one's already damaged, but in all fairness, it's just a level 40. So we're gonna get into some real action next, I think. Excuse me. Let's send them over here. I do like these at the moment, actually. They're quite fun. I'm not really sure if they can take a beating yet. I think I'm going to need to try and test them elsewhere to get more of a... Because I'm not sure how much damage these mines are giving me. So to really get an idea of whether this hole's good or not, I might have to take it out and hit like an 85 or hit something along those lines. Something in game that we already know the kind of damage it does, so we can kind of get an estimation of what we think. So that again was pretty pain free. I don't know if I should jump on a map. Someone may try and kill me. Okay, let's try something higher level. Oh, do you know what's annoying?
They have good combat speed, don't they?
They do have good combat speed, but remember, combat speed has took a bit of a boost with the whole R&D stuff, so I guess it depends on your level. Anyway, let's go into this one here, if it will ever load. Finally.
Yeah, got a 70.
70? Okay, I'll try 70, Wim. I don't know what I've just clicked. I think I've clicked an 80.
Yeah,
but thankfully, it's fully hit. It's got full health, so we can at least try these out. I'm going to send the ships there. I'm going to send the Amiga down here. I mean, this is a level 80, so this is probably second to highest. So let's see what kind of damage we're taking here. What we'll do, we'll zoom in as well, try and get a good view on this. And I'm going to send them up here. Still, I don't see any frostbites, guys, unless you see any. Frostbites or cold snaps, not visible at the moment. So that's a pretty important thing, because that basically means that you can run Harlock Ages in here, and not be too concerned about it. Thank you. Is it Cloffy? Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate that. I do stream from my own channel, but now that we've took on this venture with the Forsaken Council, I've set up the Twitch for us here. So we're going to be streaming from a lot of not just me as well. We're going to get other members of the show streaming. You know, everyone has access to the channel here, so we can all stream and do different things and try and give you the freshest advice we can.
Look at your act. There's not been any of the targets.
Well, that's brilliant, Steve. Brilliant. I'm definitely going to be talking about that as well, because that means that anything will work in here. You know, like for the players that use, say, Grimshine Wraths with carriers, not that I would say that's the way to go, but also for the players that use Harlock Aegis, Standard Aegis, I mean, that would run very well in these then. So that's a brilliant bit of advice there. They do not have cold snaps. I bet they put cold snaps in them. I bet they do. You know what I mean? It's just, otherwise everyone's just going to come in here with the old fleets that we've been running for 6 months and have an absolute field day. Because if I had a Harlock Aegis in front of these, I wouldn't be taking damage. I wouldn't be taking nowhere near as much damage. Not that I've actually taken really any damage yet. If you look at my health bar, I'm, what, is that 5%? Not even 5%. And I've done the 30, 40, and now I'm at 80. Do you see that blue beam come out again? The big blue beam. Oh, did you see the splash on the beam then? That took out all of those turrets. I'm going to watch a replay on that. Guys, I get in a minute, see my chat's, my stream's delayed to what I'm watching live. I've got the laptop next to me. I need to see that again. Whoa, that was incredible. Did you see that? That was incredible.
He is such
a... That was so good. That just took out like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 turrets in one hit. Imagine that was your base in BP. You'd be crying.
No, I wouldn't.
Yes, you would.
I wouldn't cry.
Well, you wouldn't, because your base gets farmed every day anyway.
You get smashed every day.
Smashed every day, yeah. At least you get smashed every day, so... That was incredible. I hope they bring out like new UAV crews to increase that chance as well. That would be something, wouldn't it?
Wim's telling me to smash you, but I don't know what context that's in.
Wim, did you watch the live show? Lucy announced that she gets smashed every day, apparently. And it's horrible, she says.
I meant my base.
Well, I would hope so. But it was still funny.
Yeah, you even made a meme about it. That's how lovely you are. Right,
hit
a 90 next.
I'm on my way to a 90. If the, I don't know if the guys can see. I'm going into a 90. So show me that of a 99, because that would probably be too hard for us to hit.
Oh, I see Insector Gadget.
Is Insector Gadget in?
Yeah, I just seen it. There's Monster.
Monster, Jesus. Well, they, mind you, it went public, didn't it, at 9 o'clock our time, so...
Is White Star
in there?
With his Punishers.
With his Punishers, White Star's in with it. Don't mind White Star up, Jesus. Right, this one is a level 90, so this is the hardest they're going to get. I really wish I came in on this angle here, because then I would have went clockwise. But so be it. Well, that's because I'm not stacked, which is a mistake on my part, because I should be stacked here
to
reduce, because that will basically, if that splash reduction reduces, see that blue wave there?
Yeah.
Come on! Did you see that? Whoa. These are like my new favourite thing. It's like, you know, like in Street Fighter when Ryu does that thing and that blue, like, is it an Hadouken? And the blue like beam comes out across the screen. It's just like that, you know? We've gone Street Fighter on BP. That's what's happened. We might get a yoga flame later, you never know.
You're such a child. I just watched a replay of you flicking your hand and everything.
I know, I was excited, right? I was excited, sorry. What can I say?
This guy's like, that weapon smashes the shit out of everything.
See it! See it then! Did you see it then?
Right, calm down, Liam.
Go on, that was insane.
Okay, I can see what you're building next.
Well, at that price, yeah, I will be building them next.
What was the build time again?
You can build them for under 1,000 coins a ship. I probably went for more of a lengthy build than needed. In all fairness, like I think you could probably get a cheaper build than this.
They're pretty solid, aren't they?
Well, they're very solid. I mean, this is a level 90. And yeah, I mean, what am I at? 20% damage? Not even, I'm at 10% damage.
I tried a 70 earlier, and it took my Gore Sabers 5 hits.
Well, to be fair, Lucy, they're Gore Sabers.
Yeah, no, the coaxials in them. I couldn't get a rocket on anything.
You couldn't get a rocket? Alright, cool.
You're not even listening to me.
I am listening, I swear.
I'm trying to offer advice. Don't use Gore Sabers.
I'm in a blue beam frenzy right now. My ships are Hadouken in the screen, like mad.
I would
dip
head.
Oh my, did you just see that one? That was a sweet spot one on the corner there.
You should dip back in, Liam, because there's two torque towers.
Well, I'm going to have to come back in, aren't I? Yeah, I would say that I don't know. Do you think you could bring subs in here?
Yeah, but
because I mean,
there's nothing there.
Have you seen anywhere that seems to show thermal?
No.
Because I haven't. I imagine you could bring in deluge tigers or downpour tigers, whatever you're using, and bring them in and prep out some turrets.
Arrow the Dark asks what the orange field is around your ship.
The orange field is the splash to reduction. What we'll do is, after this hit, we're going to take these back into base. I'm going to shove a Harlock Aegis with them. And then we're going to come back in, and we're going to bring this damage right down. But what that purple field is, it's an orange ring. And the purple part of it is basically indicating their tactical field. It's a friendly tactical field that reduces splash damage by 20%. And it affects all ships within it. So when you stack all four ships, okay, don't use subs, I got you there, guys. So when you stack all four ships together, if that statistic stacks, which I think it does, and I've got four ships here, then I have an 80% splash damage reduction, which means I could probably have quite a good time sitting under citadels. Like, I'm not too concerned about putting anti-morts on this fleet and running past Apox and, you know, stuff like that. Sorry?
No, I was going to ask a question, but I'm not going to ask it anymore.
Is it a dumb question?
No, I don't know.
Ask it, go on. Lucy's got a question for the chat.
I'm not going to ask it.
Just ask it.
No.
Just ask it, Lucy. There's lots of people in the chat that can help you out. I won't answer it. I'll let them answer. What is it?
I'm not asking.
Lucy wants to know, how do you spell bridge? Just kidding. Just kidding.
It's annoying me.
What is the question, Lucy?
So can you base hit with these?
So can you base hit with these? That's the question. Well, no, Lucy, no, you can't base hit these.
Why not?
Because you can't base hit with most ships.
You're so cheeky.
You
well, asked. I never actually thinking, I asked how to spell bridge.
Oh, God. yeah, you can base hit with them, Lucy. They're designed for hitting base targets because they have siege deflection. So that would I would say that would be their more of their use than anything else. Now you see, guys, what I just hit there is I hit a 20, a 40, an 80, and a 90, and I'm looking at 4 coins repair. Now, if I repair one by one and use the 5 minutes, etc., I could probably bring that down to 3 coins and just, you know, wait 6 minutes and then speed up 5. So that's pretty good. That's pretty damn good. What we'll do now is we will put an Aegis with them. I definitely want to try different ships. Like, I want to take different ships out. So we're going to try Citadels in this base. This is my beautiful Citadel fleet that I built a couple of weeks ago. And Lucy killed me when she seen the cost. But this is also my beautiful little fleet. I replaced my Rhinos with Zoes. How magical is that? And this is something I'm considering building. So I built it in here to test it out. This is Prototype Hunters. Anyway, let's get back to it. So let's take off that Harlock Aegis there and let's shove it in here. I'm not sure if the speed matches, so I might have to adjust this. Oh, shite. We're overweight. Right, what's the combat speed here? 31. I'm not even sure I'm going to get an Aegis to 31. Let's refit this bad boy. And let's take, then we're going to need a combat speed buff here. I'll tell you what, let's put on this to give it a combat speed buff. That takes us to 27. Let's put on some V's. How about that? Now we're in the magic zone. 29. What did I say the speed buff the other one was?
I don't know, it wasn't last time.
You never listen.
Where's
I know what to put on. Oh, I've got uranium. I was going to say streamlined cadmium. No uranium in here for some reason. That takes it to 30. I want to give it a similar range to... I'm going to put something on it to try and give it a similar range to the ships here. And I'm going to have to refit this again afterwards, which is a pain in the ass. Let's go for the 94 launcher. Down there, and the pod. Okay. We're still overweight, which is fantastic. What we could do is strip all this off. How much weight over are we? 38,800. So we're only 700 tons over, so let's just quickly adjust that. That should do the trick. Let's have a look. There we go. Level 60, no, level 52 fleet. Okay, that's not too bad. What's the armor on these things? Not 20k. I've really lost some armor on that, but so be it. Okay, let's go. Let's give them a go. So we've switched out the Omega. So we've lost some ballistic defense and we've lost some ballistic reload. These are legendary, so will that matter? Let's find out. What we'll do is we will go into...
Hey, what chat?
What did he say?
He went, hey, gay boy.
Also, a position has just opened on the Forsaken Council. Just kidding.
What'd you say?
I just wanted that gadget.
Insect gadget.
Right, what have we tried? 90. Is there anything harder than 90? Fuck's sake. Excuse my French. Let's try this 90 here. Hopefully that guy hasn't hit. Yeah, let's try this. So we've got we've took out the Omega Behemoth that was leading this. So we've lost some ballistic defense and ballistic reload. We'll find out how big of a difference that makes. And we'll see what happens. But we're going to run the ages, and the reason we're going to run the ages is because of the
something.
The cryofields. Now that didn't really those cryofields did not affect really my fleet setup that I was taking in there a minute ago. As you've seen, we hit a level 30, a level 40, a level 80, and a level 90, and we took four coins worth of damage. Only just 4 coins of damage, really. So, is the Aegis even needed? That's you know, is it even needed? Now you can see, I think when you see these little glowy sort of rings, I think that is them reducing the splash damage. When you see this little circle of, it looks like a circle of fire, like a ripple on the water. And I think when you see that, that is the splash damage being reduced. So if I think using that, it's going to be very easy to spot which weapons are giving you splash damage in these.
Your mic is off,
then. It says bye. Oh, see you later, Steve. All the best, mate. Take care, and thanks for the info. Yeah, we can go. What I'll do is I'll go into my base after this level 90. We'll try out this Horlock Aegis, and then what I'll do is I'll go into my base after this level 90, and we'll do it again.
You're actually taking more damage, look.
Well, actually, the Horlock Aegis is taking a fair bit of damage here.
Is it?
It is, but the Centurions, is it Centurions? They're taking nothing.
Exactly, look.
So to be quite frank with you, I mean, I don't even think an Horlock Aegis is advisable at all.
No, because you're doing a lot better without it.
Yeah, I mean, the Omega gave me that 50% ballistic defense, and that seems to be where most of my damage is coming from in here. Jesus Christ. Did you see that? I'm not going to get too excited about that one, but that was impressive.
I
can't even hear that. I had 3 in a row then.
You get too excited, seriously. So Astromax is saying, what hull and weapon are you using?
I'll show you now, Astromax. We're going to go into my base now. This is the new hull. I built 4 of them, and I ran them with an Omega Behemoth, which quite honestly was the best setup. I've decided, for the purpose of the video, to remove the Omega Behemoth and bring in a Horlock Aegis, because these mines, they have no frostbite turrets and they have no cold snap turrets. That gives you the option to use a Horlock Aegis, because obviously I don't think you could build them with frostbites and cold snaps, because these new holes themselves have a field of effect, which would be obsolete if they put those turrets in here. So you can use an Aegis, you can use a Horlock Grimshine Berserker, and a Grimshine Wrath. You could use anything that has a cryofield that we've stopped using because of cold snaps. You can now use in these mines, which is a benefit, but I'm just not sure it's even worth bringing a Horlock Aegis into these unless you're running very low end tech. But these holes are absolutely eating these alive. So they're definitely, I believe it was said to us last week, and we talked about it on the show, that these holes are specifically designed to kill these mines. It's a fleet that's been designed to deal with this kind of thing. So what I think we should do is try out some older holes in these bases to see if anyone that's not going to be able to get them is viable. And it looks like we've been sniped. Yes, we've been
sniped. Right, fleet stack. You're terrible at FVF, do you know that?
I don't need to fleet stack. A fleet stack is probably the worst thing, because these things deal splash.
Well, spread out then. Spread them. Oh, wow, this is interesting.
It is.
They're not even dying. That's hilarious. How boring.
I know, this is really boring. Look at this guy bothered.
Oh,
Wasting our time, eh?
Right, okay. One down.
Yeah.
One down.
We're aiming for the next one.
Yeah, I'll get all of them in, not the same one.
He hasn't
killed
one of yours yet.
No, it's because I think it's because I got the Aegis in there.
Who is it that's hitting you?
Fuck, God knows.
You're going to the F word there.
Oh no, you always, he probably knows I'm streaming, fancied a little. Anyway, it's all good fun. I don't feel bad, you know, don't.
He killed another one.
Yeah, he's not got one of mine yet.
He's running, look.
He's running. No. Don't run.
Take the pain. Whee. I think my sound effects are the best.
Yeah, Lucy does provide good fun. And now Lucy fill it in with some of the pew pew. Yeah, cool story, bro. Thanks for sniping me. You didn't kill a ship and you lost your whole fleet. Hope you enjoyed that.
You should have sung that the whole time.
La 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 la. Yeah.
You're absolutely bonkers.
Yeah, I know. But all the best ones are eccentric. So. I remember last time I was in the preview, what was funny about the preview I was in last time is everyone was coming to hit my base because I was in the preview and fell in my base, and it made the video that much more successful. It was fantastic to get the fails on video. Oh shit, I wasn't meant to rewatch, excuse me. Didn't mean to swear.
I think you should put a pound in the swear jar.
We should have a swear jar, shouldn't we? It's just I'm not really that wealthy to keep paying that swear jar. Right, let's recall these a minute, because what we're going to do is we're going to run through the fleet again for everyone that asked. Excuse me.
I think that build you've got is quite good.
It's not a bad build. I think it's probably the best build you could use in... Or what... I don't know if it's the best build, but it's certainly a good build. I actually think that they should be faster. I think streamlined Cadium would actually be... Because it would be faster and it would be cheaper to repair. But I'll run through with what I've got on there. I took their radioactive defense up as much as I could. That was the plan. I'm going to put this fleet back together as it was before, because this fleet was... I took 4 coins of damage doing like a 40, a 30, an 80, and a 90 with the fleet set up like this.
Insector wants to be a mod.
Stop
bitching,
Insector. You want to be a mod? Sorry, one second. I don't know if I can... do that from here, Insector.
You're lying, you done it earlier for me.
I did it from my computer, but I'd have to go small screen and that would affect the stream.
Suck it up, Insector.
Sorry, Insector. Right, let's get these fleets put back together a minute.
I just totally bombed that in the background there, it was brilliant to watch.
What?
Look.
What's up with
you? Just watch the video. Sorry,
I don't know what you're talking about, Lucy. Right. So, there was people in the chat that wanted to go through this whole again. So, what we will do is we will go through this whole again. Let's go into the holes. The holes. Fill the holes with bells of joy. Right. Centurion. Forsaken hole. A specialized Forsaken ballistic hull built to withstand specific siege targets. In addition, the Centurion provides an aura that reduces splash damage dealt to nearby friendly ships. This effect will stack multiplicatively, multiplicatively with other Centurion ships. Now, is that multiplicatively means that it does stack, so it'll be 20% plus 20% plus 20%.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're not saying
done. Ballistic damage is plus 55%. Ballistic range is plus 40%. Ballistic reload is plus 40%. Siege deflection is 475. It has no assault deflection. Evade bonus is plus 30%. Its ballistic defense is plus 50 and its radioactive defense is plus 50. Let me tell you, I've just been in these bases and I can tell you what the two things I've seen there. You don't need anything other than layered armor and radioactive defense, because that's the only damage I've given out at this time. I don't see any secondary damage. I see ballistic damage and I see radioactive damage. So this hull is perfect as it stands. Let's have a look at its movement. Map speed, 35 miles per hour. Pretty decent. Combat speed is 18, which is pretty fast for a hull before it's been, you know, equipped with any specials. And its turn speed is 13. The miscellaneous. Repair duration is 1 hour and 33 minutes. Its weapon slots are 10. Its armor slots are 5, and its special slots are 5. Its cargo is 5.231 million. 5,231,000. Its special abilities, this is the interesting part. Its fire field resistance is plus 75%. Okay, so we all know what that means. It resists fire fields by three quarters, which is pretty significant. The field of effect type is friendly. This is the thing that the guy was talking about in the chat earlier. This is the little ring around it and the purple icon above the ship's head. This is its special ability. So it has a friendly tactical field that affects all the ships within that range. The range is only 20, which is equivalent to one land tile. And that gives it a splash damage reduction of 20%. So if you're running four ships, like I was running four ships a minute ago, then you've got 80% splash reduction. Now, I can tell you from knowledge that I've seen dug up about these Draconian turrets that are in these bases. They're the same ones that are in the Drake Uranium bases. They're ballistic cannons that do splash damage, pretty significant splash damage, which means when the cannon hits one ship, its damage is also splashed, so it splashes to every ship in that area. So that's a very significant reduction, because it means that you can stack and you can take these on and not get absolutely mauled by one cannon hitting one ship. It's a very significant reduction. Tactical modules, it affects all ships in any state. Okay, so that's its friendly field. So that is the Centurion. Let's have a look at the weapon. Let's scroll down. The weapon is very impressive. You wait till you see its bonus ability. I'm not sure on the way it looks. It doesn't look anything like a ballistic cannon. Do you know what I mean? It doesn't look anything like a ballistic cannon at all. Don't get me wrong, the little Hadoukens that shoot out of it, you know, the Hadoukens that come out of it, that looks like it matches, but it doesn't look like it fires little orange like shells, you know, that we've seen there. Let's read it out. So it's a particle accelerator cannon, a ballistic cannon that is most effective when battling against siege targets. This cannon has a chance to fire a particle blast, dealing ballistic splash damage that devastates nearby structures. This effect can only occur once per equipped particle accelerator cannon, every 10 seconds. So for every cannon equipped to your ship, that cannon has a potential to do this every 10 seconds. So if it does it, it's not going to be able to do it again for 10 seconds. But wait till you see the statistics on the chance of it doing it, and then you'll probably understand that you'd be very lucky to get one in 10 seconds, every 10 seconds. Weapon type is cannon. Damage type is ballistic. The weight is pretty decent. It's 285 tons. It's very good, in fact. Armor points plus 200. I think that's kind of needed, looking at the way I've built that Centurion. I think that actually fits in quite well. Splash is 6, which is not really that high. I mean, that's the equivalent of 1.5 walls. So that's not a lot of splash. I mean, you can boost that if you want, but it's kind of pointless. It does mean that when you would take on bases, like player bases, and you shoot through walls, that it will hit two walls next to it. So you'll be hitting three walls at once when you try and shoot through walls to take out a turret. That's the benefit of it. It kind of gives it that siege cannon effect. It also means that if you are targeting a ship on a fleet that's fleet stacked, then you will the damage will be across all the ships in that stack because it's splashing in a range of 6. So that's the benefit of having it, although it's very low. And if you're thinking, oh, I know, I'll put high explosive shells free on it, you know, that works. That will boost its splash by 50%, which is free, which takes it to 9, which is still 2.1 wall spaces. So it's kind of pointless. Kind of pointless boosting the splash on that. Just leave it and forget it. The range is 50, the damage is 200, the building damage is 1350, and the wall damage is 1350. So pretty weak and pointless against ships. Don't even try to shoot a Punisher with this. And honestly, don't even waste time thinking, oh, I might put it in my base guard, because that would be the most silliest idea of all.
Liam, what's the build time of the blank hole?
We'll get to that in a sec, the build time of the blank hole. I'll go on that in a sec. So the reload time is 3 seconds, which is ridiculously good. When you think about a skull ranked fleet with an Amiga running it, well, you'll see that they're obviously, for me, I think they're firing at their minimum, absolute minimum range they can be. So they're not really getting boosted from my Amiga, but they are getting their ballistic defense boosted. So it's worth it. Their accuracy is 80. Excuse me. As we know, the accuracy is 80, which means it has a chance to miss. But guess what? This weapon does splash damage, so it never misses. Even if you miss and the shell goes just next to the ship, you're still going to hit it off the 6 splash. So the accuracy is almost an irrelevant stat on this hull. The repair duration is 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Okay, that's pretty decent. Okay, now we're into special abilities. This is where it gets interesting. The secondary weapon, Particle Blast. Now, that is the blue Hadouken I was describing. That is the blue beam that jets across the screen and looks like, you know, Hiroshima's just gone off. It just takes out everything. The splash is 40, which is equal to 2 land tiles. Okay, so that's it's going to take out a big, big area. The trigger cooldown is 10 seconds, which we've already read in its description. The trigger chance is a 0.3%. Now, that means that every time a shot fires, there's a 0.3% chance that that shot is going to be the blue beam. Mathematically thinking, that means that you're going to have, well, 10 shots is 3%. So 100 shots is 30%. So 300 shots. So you've got, I think it's something like 1 in 330. You've got a 1 in 330 chance of getting that. Now, I don't know how accurate that is, but that's mathematically how you would explain that statistic, a 1 in 330 chance of getting that boost. But they don't work like that. I just have loads of them. I had 3 in 1 volley a minute ago. So I don't know if that's working as intended or if that is incorrect or if I'm misunderstanding that mathematically, and if I am, feel free to correct me. But anyway, yeah, so you've got a 1 in 330 chance for a blue beam, which seems to be working far, far better than that. The splash is 40, so when this thing goes off and does its blue wave of death, it's splash of 40, its spread is 200, its range is 50, so it's the same range as the cannon. Its damage is 2,000 to a ship. Its building damage is 113,460. That's enough damage to wipe out anything we've got in our player bases. Although I don't think these hulls are really built for player bases. I think you could use them in player bases, but I think they're built for Drake Uranium bases and Drake bases, Drake targets. The weapon type is a cannon. Damage type is ballistic. So I don't know if any of you guys in the chat here have hit Drake Uranium bases. But there is a cannon in there that has 1 million health points. So this is going to help. This is going to be a good fleet for that. Let's have a look at the fleet I built. I'll build another fleet for a purpose of the video anyway. But this is the fleet I built. And it was partly due to some people in the chat were also saying, give it radioactive defense because you need it in those mines. And actually you do. You do need radioactive defense in those mines. I've got a reflective coating 3, siege battery 3. I don't regret that. I think that was the best thing I put on this ship. Okay. Heavy plating 3, speed system 5, nuclear accelerators. In all honesty, for these mines, I actually don't think I would change the special here. I don't think I would need to. I think that's the perfect setup. The armor slots could change. We could change these armor slots, no problem, because it doesn't actually need any missile defense from what I see. Was I even hit by missiles? I can't think I was hit by missiles. So I would maybe just, we're getting hit by radioactive. And we're getting hit by radioactive and we're getting hit by ballistic. So we want high evade, high ballistic defense, and high radioactive defense. So, I mean, I did stack these for the purpose of the assault and siege deflection boost. But I kind of almost feel that it's irrelevant. I kind of feel this fleet would run a lot better with higher radioactive defense and higher ballistic defense. So yeah, so this is the fleet I was using for the purpose of this video. It is 17 days and 21 hours. I think what we'll do is we will try something different and build some more because we just can while we're here. I think let's go for more radioactive defense and let's go for some more evade because these things are, and you know what, it doesn't need heavy plating. I can tell you that now, it doesn't need heavy plating because I'm sure it was only ballistics hitting me. I reckon you can run layered armor free on this and take next to no damage at all. So let's have a look at that. Ballistic defense, 83. Radioactive defense, 73. Yeah, I think let's build four of these. See how they run. I reckon they'll run better. I took four coins damage. Well, we'll test out both builds. Well, wait, I'll bugger it. I'd have to rank these again, though, as well, which is going to cost a lot of gold. How many have I built so far? Excuse me. Okay, one more. So, also, I don't have any rogue crews either, so I haven't been able to test out rogue crews, which is a real pain in the ass. But anyway, so that's that fleet there. We've just built a second fleet. So what we'll do is we'll take this fleet out, we'll see how much damage we get, and then we'll come back and we'll try the other fleet. The other fleet, I've basically ignored explosive defense, missile defense. I've got rid of the deflection stat boosts on this second fleet. And I've gone for as high radioactive and as high ballistic defense as I can possibly get. So we'll see how that goes. We'll see how that goes in a minute. We've gone for higher evade as well. Let's try this one and see how we go.
Try
4DU5
on it.
4DU5. Well, again, I'm just experiencing here, and this only
that
comes.
From metal militia.
The only reason I don't think it needs that metal, is that the one that gives 7% to every stat?
I think so.
The only reason it doesn't need that is because I don't see where you're getting any explosive or missile damage in there. I've yet to see it, unless I'm looking wrong.
Everyone's fighting
everyone. Yeah, it looks like there's a lot of PvP going on. I don't know why, because this isn't a PvP hole, so they're absolutely wasting their time, but fair play to them. I'll use the server for what it was designed for. But yeah, there's a lot of PvP going on, Lucy, you're right.
Treat it like a Draconian fleet.
Yeah, exactly, that's why I'm treating it like a Draconian fleet. Maximum ballistic, a Draconian fleet doesn't need radioactive, but maximum ballistic and maximum turret defense. That's a Drake Uranium fleet.
He's on
metal,
just Facebook me, that's all.
Oh, right, no worries. No, I mean, this one metal, this, because it has a radioactive, I think you want maximum radioactive and maximum ballistic. You don't need anything else. Let me have take a second look, because.
You should get rid of M and use DU5.
DU5. Well. I know. The only reason the M's on there, Mel, if you're watching, is simply for the additional assault deflection, because that could be taking their ballistic cannons down to their minimum damage, and that's why I'm using it. It is worthwhile for that reason only. But as I said, these were built prior to seeing what was in these. Anyway. Let's rock and roll.
What level are you
in? This is a level 90. This is the fleet I've been using, and I love, and may build in the game. Very, almost, if not exactly like this. Although when I get these in the game, I expect to have D5X. So that may be a difference for me. And I may build them slightly differently, that they'll take more damage in here, but less damage hitting player bases. See, as you can see, do you see any missiles? No missiles, no mortars, no nothing. This is just ballistic and radioactive defense in here. So that's all you need to build if you're going to tailor a fleet to these. It's a shame I don't have my Drake Uranium basically fully finished, because if I did, I would test that in there to show to show if it operates better than these do.
Yeah, to come on.
Well, it's because I would build it here, but I don't have the uranium, and you need 90k uranium per hole. There's that amazing Hadouken going off there. Yep, that's my new name for it. The Hadoukens. These are the Street Fighters of the ship world.
Should call them Flashers.
Flashers, that's you, isn't it?
No, I meant, because
the Flashers. I should call them the Flashers.
No, you know what I meant, because it goes flash boom.
It goes flash boom. You know what, Kixi? If you do not have someone that does sound effects, I think I know a person just for you.
Flash boom.
Flash boom. Actually, I wonder what the sound effects are like for this cannon.
No, don't put it on. You had it too loud earlier.
Wow. It's for the purposes of the stream. Just kidding. Smashers, not flashers. That's it. She ain't smashing, she's flashing. Well, thank you guys as well. I see we've got, you know, a nice number in the stream watching us live, and I really appreciate that. It's great to see the community come out and get involved, and you know, it makes it all worthwhile to know that you're not here sort of streaming to a dead audience. You know, it's great to see the community's reaction to the new show and to the new page. It's just been absolutely phenomenal. You know, this past week has been absolutely buzzing. So we've been having such a good time with the show. We're all really, really, really buzzing about it. So I don't know if you guys know, but I put a poll up in the page about base parts, and obviously these are going to be what you get base parts from. Your opinions on that would be really, really appreciated, because I'm trying to compile some information to pass over to Kicks, you know, if they'll be so kind as to listen. And the show tomorrow, we're doing an open mic night where we invite people from the page to come into a hangout. So we'll invite people from the page to come into a hangout, chat away with us, and talk on the show for an hour. And it will just be like a chance for you guys to chat to us and express your views on it. And from that show will actually be specifically about base parts.
I swear that Squire is JB.
So that will be specifically about base parts. And that show will also be passed on and watched by Kickside. So we want people's opinions on these base parts. They're very, very, very interested to hear what the community are thinking about this. And rightly so, because at the end of the day, you're the guys that have got to play with it. So, Jesus, I did a Lucy. You're the guys that have got to use the feature.
No, play with that. Say again.
You're the guys that have got to play with the feature. So they're definitely interested to know what you feel, to know what you think.
Know what you feel.
What is it with you?
What? I didn't do anything.
You've got to take it lower.
Yeah, take it lower. You're terrible.
Oh, God. Do you see what I have to put up with, guys, on a day-to-day basis?
Hey, your life would be boring without me.
So come on, let me get back to where we were. So come on to the show tomorrow, guys. I know I don't mean to whittle on about this, but come on to the show, get involved, you know. I want to hear what you're saying. I want to know what you feel about this feature. So please come in. Okay, so as you can see there, guys, we took 49 minutes of damage. 49 minutes of damage for a level 99. That's the hardest target they're creating. That's pretty impressive off the bat. We will try some old crappy holes in a minute. But let me see if I've got enough gold left to rank this fleet up and test this fleet out. Because I got a funny feeling I can beat that. In fact, I think with some of the newer tech that's coming out as well, I think I can get these down to a free repair.
Yeah,
If I could get a rogue crew on him, I definitely could. Anyway, this is going to rip my gold to shreds. I'm not sure we've got enough to rank these. No.
So see your repair time just now, is that half time or is that full repair? Half repair or full repair?
This is full repair. This is full repair. There's no half repair active. This is not a raid format. We're not hitting raid targets right now. We're hitting the new mines that are going to be released on the 15th of March, which is the day after the raid ends. So on the Monday that the raid ends, is it not the 15th? The 14th is when the raid ends. It's a Monday, and the day after that is a Tuesday, which is our beautiful update that we tend to have. And that is when they will roll out this update that will bring in base parts, which is what I've been talking about. Base parts. listen, guys, actually, while we're here, I thought of a new catchphrase, right? And I want to see what you all think.
No, don't do it.
I want to see what you all think, right? So when the show starts.
Look at the camera and do it.
No, when the show starts, right, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go, hi, it's BP time with Liam99. right, or I'm gonna go, hi, it's BP time with me, your host, Liam99. What do you think of that? It's BP time with me, Liam99.
No.
I thought I could, like, that would catch on. That would be like a thing in the game.
You said camp.
Camp?
Yeah.
Hi, it's BP time with me, your host, Liam99.
Oh god.
Is that camper?
Yeah.
Right, okay. How about, hi, it's Liam99, BP time.
You should do like a Darth Vader one.
I can't do Darth Vader. Use the Forsaken, Luke.
Luke, I am your father. That was terrible. Yeah, I can do lightsaber sound, listen.
Do you know Lucy, right? Lucy one time, right? I got actually had a scene because I almost split up with her after this. Right, right. I can't legendary rank these guys, but anyway, we'll just run with them as they are, so this may not be as good of a test.
What story are we going to tell?
I'd like. Now, the story is, right, that I was sat with Lucy watching Lord of the Rings, okay? Now, this mortified me, this did, so I want to see what everyone thinks about this. We were sat watching Lord of the Rings, and Lucy turned to me and said, doesn't he turn into Darth Vader at the end? We were watching Lord of the Rings, and there was Frodo was on the screen. And she said, doesn't Frodo turn into Vader at the end? I could not believe that. That was like end relationship material right there.
I got confused. It's easy to get confused between those two films.
It's not. One's with swords and one's with laser beams. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm sorry. Jeez.
Jesus.
But do you want to hear my lightsaber effects? You ready?
Your lightsaber sound effects.
Yeah, right.
Right. That sounds like Formula One.
Oh, it's so good.
What kind of lightsabers have you been watching?
Well.
Trying to come on here and do a professional stream. I'm putting up with this. Do apologise. I'm trying to find a level 90, but everyone's killing the 90s or they're not spawning.
Well, stop driving about, just hit something.
Bloody hit you in a minute.
You're going to get sniped.
Well, that didn't work out too well last time for him, did it? Alright, I might have to go and hit a level 80, guys, I'm sorry. No, because then my test is void. I'm trying to test out which build is better. One just spawned there, but it's not a 90. What's that one? Oh, I'm sorry, guys. I'm trying to find a 90 for you. Excuse me. What's that one? There is no 90s. There is no 90s.
One 90 is the south of you.
South of my base?
Yeah. That's north.
That was north. Thank you, Lucy.
So silly.
We are a bit silly, aren't we? Well, you got to have fun.
Down there.
Where?
I'm looking at your screen. I went where and looked across the room.
Yeah. Okay, what we'll do, we'll hit an 80, just so you guys aren't bored. Then we'll repair and we'll come back. Alright.
I guess I'll tag you if he wants to play.
He wants the equalizer.
The equalizer.
Equal. It's time to be equal.
That was quite cool.
That was a brilliant film, The Equalizer. Remember Denzel Washington?
Who's Denzel Washington?
Denzel? The big Denz dog.
I don't even know who Denzel Washington is.
Denzel Washington is like the best actor in the world. Remember he was that retired, like,
the guy that said Taken.
We see Denzel Washington's black. The guy in Taken's Liam Neeson, he's white.
Oh, right. The guy that plays, what's that film? Bruce Lightning.
Bruce Lightning.
Bruce Almighty.
Lucy, we're going to have a bloody talk. You know that? I can't keep doing this. No, Denzel Washington, The Equalizer. I'm false advertising there, but anyway. Denzel Washington in The Equalizer, he plays that, he's like a retired assassin. He's like the best in the world and he's retired. And that girl gets kidnapped by the Russian gangsters. And then he goes like avenging her.
I
made you watch it with me and you loved it. You were like...
Is Denzel Washington that film he's seen?
No, you're
Matrix.
Talking about Shawshank Redemption.
No, I'm talking about Matrix. Is he in that?
You're asking if Denzel Washington played Morpheus in The Matrix?
Yes.
That no. I just can't cope.
Lol, I made you watch it.
Yeah, I watched it on TV and it was that good. I said, Lucy, I've got a really good film, and I told her about it, and then she's like, oh, I'll watch it. So I actually sat down and watched it the next day with her as well. So I watched it twice. It's a really good film. I'm sure it was called The Equalizer. It was called The Equalizer.
Sounds like quite a robot film.
No, it's not a robot film. Denzel Washington is a... Denzel Washington is like a retired assassin, right? He's hiding. He's give up. He's retired.
Okay, I knew what you said.
And they kidnap this Russian girl who's... I think she is a prostitute. And they kidnap her. And then he goes looking for her because he likes her.
This cloth guy's really good. He knows all the actors. Fishburne.
Yeah, Lawrence Fishburne. He also went into CIS, didn't he?
The name is Fishburne. Fishy Fishburne.
You're getting silly now. No more Coca-Cola for you. No more sweets for you. You've got too much sugar.
I only have one glass of lemonade. Please no.
Too much sugar. I was actually going to watch a film tonight that I haven't seen yet. But I decided to, but then the stream got announced. Terminator Genesis. If anyone's seen that, and is it good? Because it came on to Sky Movies today. I'm going to watch it after this stream. Anyway, we're supposed to be talking about BP. We've gone completely off topic here. Completely.
Okay, let's kill shit then.
Right, I'm trying to. Trying to do it.
I think you should try like a uranium base with these.
I don't think the bases are open.
And they are, they're on the map.
I haven't seen a sector threat bar.
Oh my god, no way. Are you for real?
Yeah, you got to fill up the bars when not the bases, so.
Well, they're open, they don't have bubbles around them. If they usually have them. There, see?
That's just the standard Drake bases, babe, not the Drake uranium bases.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, so the what was different about that hit is it wasn't level 90, and I am not talking sense right now. That was a slightly different build to the other fleet. So we're trying out a different build here. But until we find a level 90, I can't really give you an informative test. There's a level 90. Come here, my children.
We'll click attack then.
No, I need to repair them.
Right, I guarantee you'll stop there. Someone will snipe you, then someone else will go in and take it.
If that happens. Hey, there's White Star.
Where?
There, let's kill him.
Oh, where's his Punishers?
He's there. Oh, he's going for my thing. White Star, come to dad.
Come.
I got in. Oh, he got away. Sorry, guys.
What if he's
he's probably cursing my name right now.
I bet you've lost that name too.
Oh, I don't care. I'll have to find another one. They are spawning, which is good.
I love Waitstar. He's so funny. I think his pause is what gets me.
He was trying to get me in TeamSpeak before this, but sorry, I couldn't get in there. I'm going to get in there after. Where is the 90?
It's back up. No, right. Left, sorry, left.
No, I know, but that one's gone now. I'm sorry, it's gone.
Told you.
Sorry, guys.
See? You're just an idiot.
Without rank, I don't think they'll ever be as good anyway, though, because the other fleet's legendary ranked, so it's a very difficult test to make here. What we will start doing in a minute, though, is we are going to test other fleets. Okay, it's pretty clear to me that... Yeah, let's just do that. Let's just do that instead of wasting our time here. It's pretty clear to me that that these ships are built for these bases.
Empires, then you start.
These ships are built for these bases, and they're designed to hit these mines. So, and they can do it very well and very efficiently. They're very powerful, and we could quite easily be using these fleets to hit player bases. So the verdict on these ships are they're pretty damn good. That's my verdict on these ships, and that boost effect is also pretty damn good. I do know one thing.
Do you?
I need to refit this again. I took everything off of it to put... I took everything off of it to try out in leading a fleet of these. Because these bases don't have cold snaps and frostbites, these new mines, you could...
I'm holding the sugar.
What the hell?
What is it?
Nothing. I'm not sure I'm supposed to show that. I don't know. There's some stuff in there that hasn't been released yet.
We should have moved up.
Yeah, apologies about that, but I don't think anyone caught it. But there's some tech in here that isn't out yet.
Way to be obvious about it.
Well, I didn't know it'd be there, so it's not my fault. Apologies to Kix, but you know, they should have been more clear on that. Anyway, let's carry on. I'm looking for a Harrier missile. Can anyone see the Harriers? There they are, Harrier missile. And let's try and put the ship back to how I had it a minute ago. Just for the purpose of the video, of course. I believe it did have. It didn't have V's on it. It had D5 E's.
Wim says it's the best stream ever.
Do you, Wim? Thank you very much. Well, we try and keep it comical, but most of that is actually real. It's not putting on anything. Lucy is sometimes just that funny.
Word to it.
Yeah, and the lack of coffee is very apparent. Isn't it, Lucy?
Tough titties.
Tough titties, yes, tough titties indeed.
Oh, you say titties weird. Say it again.
Titties! Remember, but
not
really.
Is that not Stu from Family Guy? He was titties.
I don't know. And I do apologise for the use of language in the video for anyone that is underage. Right. Okay. Let's test this fleet out. So I'll show you the build here, guys. This is pretty much a standard Aegis setup. Nothing fantastic going on there. This is probably, again, a standard Zoe Rhino setup. All the mod cons except for Agility 4. They're running Agility 3. And there's a Punisher and there's a Decoy. We're going to be brave now. And we're going to take this fleet into these bases to try it out. We're going to run a Punisher tank up front with the Aegis and the free Rhinos behind. If you do ever go to try this fleet out, I would suggest you run... I would suggest that you run something to boost the missiles. Perhaps I would say Wharf Rats, is it? That gives you like the 15% critical hit chance with missiles. That actually is something I use when I hit 85s with this fleet, because I can actually do 85s for free with this fleet. For free. Which is great. I can do my weeklies for nothing. Live the dream. And I can do the 101 mega holes, I think, for like a few coins with this fleet. Now that it's built to this spec, I can do the chokehold elite campaign for a few coins with this fleet. That's the elite variant, not the standard. So it's a good fleet. It's a current fleet. Is it current to these bases? That's the problem.
Cal Jericho thinks it will barely get shot in.
Well, let's find out. I tell you what.
I'm doing accents when I'm reading stuff out. I'm going to try my American accent.
He'll barely get a shot in. Well, this is a level 80, so this isn't even the toughest one. The problem here is the radioactive damage. The Drac Cox.
Is op mental. It even shoots down launchers.
The coaxial. The Draconian coaxial.
Oh, that's insane. Well, look at the damage in your fleet already.
Yeah, that's significant.
I tried to do this earlier and I kept dying. It's really tough. Look at the coaxials. They're insane.
Yeah, I can see. I can see.
Insane.
I just took a coaxial out.
Well done, Liam.
Yeah, you don't want to be doing this without a Punisher. That's something I'll tell you right now.
Jeez. K is a noob.
What? You're a bloody noob, Lucy. But you're a nice noob.
What even is noob? Like, is that it's a French word, isn't it?
It means you're not good at games. I don't really
so
know
it's
where
like
it came from.
A game or insult. You're a noob. Like that.
Yeah, these coaxials hurt. Well, they don't hurt, but they hurt my firepower.
I told you.
Well, I don't need you to tell me, but I have to test this out, because let's be real here. Not everyone is going to be able to coin a fleet of Centurions.
No, I know, but I'm just
right? Now, let's be fair. These Centurions, I just took down earlier on with my Centurions. I took down a level 90 base for 49 minutes damage. We've got that on video, because this will be going to YouTube after, so we've got that on video. We know we can take down a level 90 base with Centurions for 2 coins, one coin if you're willing to wait, and I'm almost sure I can get that down to less than 1 coin. I can get that to a free repair, I'm sure I can. Okay, and I imagine that they'll be able to rip Draconian Uranium bases apart much of the same.
How's that turret killing working out for you there, Liam?
Well, it's not working out too well, but bear in mind I'm running Harrier missiles on this fleet. So I do have and the reason I tend to pick Harrier missiles over standard missiles is because of the 50% missile bypass, which is kind of not effective on these bases. So if you had blade missiles on your Harriers, on your Zoes, sorry, you would probably have a lot better time here, because you'd be ripping these turrets a lot faster due to the increased building damage. Also, if I had a rogue crew on and I was getting a critical hit I'd be getting a few of those every volley, which would give me double damage. That would make a big difference too. So we're kind of running a little bit handicapped here. But that's fine, because a lot of people still run Harriers. A lot of people don't have blades, so it's good to test this out. I have a fleet that does run blades, but they're Kodiaks and they would last 2 minutes in there. I tell you what we'll do as well in a minute, is we'll bring Centurions in. How about that? I've got a fleet of Centurions. My build, I've built them in game, and not just coined them in air. They're actually something I coined last week in the game and got beat up for it by Lucy. So she's like, my credit card. No, Liam, my credit card. You can't use it.
You use my credit card.
Oh, I used my credit card.
Oh, right, sorry.
Right, yeah, you didn't get a joke, but it's fine. You don't get a lot of jokes.
Liam!
Use the force, Frodo.
Red laser, and you can be the green one.
The what? The red laser?
Yeah.
Babe, if you call lightsabers lasers, you'll probably offend a lot of Star Wars fanatics. Just so you know.
serious.
It's pretty serious, actually. They're a rowdy bunch, those Star Wars fans. Don't start calling them Star Trek fans, because then you'll really be in trouble.
Star Trek's in space.
Star Trek's in space. That's a beautiful observation. There's no flies around you, Lucy, is there? Definitely in space, yeah. I thought it was the Black Sea.
No, Star Trek's in space. Lord of the Rings is...
Where's that set?
In any midget houses.
In midget houses? But is it, which, where is it set?
Where they live.
Where they, it's set where they live, right.
And what's that one? Darth Vader is...
Darth Vader, yeah.
Is Lord, no... What's, you know, yeah, that's in space.
Okay. So, that was painful, guys, wasn't it? That was really, 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 really painful.
Mm-hmm.
For a level 80, for a level 80, I think we're going to be licking our wounds there. I reckon you're looking at about 12 coins.
Licking your wounds. Really? Did you die?
No, I killed it.
For your police officer?
That's not my fleet. That's someone called Hardcore.
Oh, right.
He likes to go hardcore.
I think the name gave it away. Yeah. Hi, I'm Hardcore. I like to be hardcore.
Yeah, let's see the damage on this, guys, because I'm not impressed with that. 13 coins. Yeah, I called it at 12. Look, here is the damage I took on a level 90. We've still got it there. That's proof that we took that damage on a level 90. Unbelievable. And there's the damage on probably one of the most modern fleets around. All right, that's not, you know, we're talking about Zoe Rhinos with all the latest technology on them, a Punisher tank, and a Harlock Aegis sat back protecting them all with its field of effect. And that's the damage they took. This fleet had no field of effect. Its field of effect doesn't boost their resistances, and somehow that's its damage. That to me spells out that if you don't build these ships, you're going to have a lot of trouble in these mines. Now, with those super sexy Draconian coaxials that I do not have, by the way, yes, I'm suffering. My base is running free forsaken coaxials. Thank you, Kix. So, yeah. And my cold snap is still not built. Ugh. But it will be built. It will still be built. It starts building tomorrow in my real game, please. Anyway.
In your real game.
So here's the fleet. Honestly, I need a crew on this fleet. I need something to boost the mortars. But bugger it. Let's go. Let's give them a try. Level 59 fleet. Once the tanks are dead, the fleet's dead. That much I do know. We're not going to go into a level 90 with this because we want to avoid the pain. Let's try the same test that we just put the Zoes under. What's unfortunate here, guys, is that I do not know what base part level payouts you get from these. So I can't give you any kind of good information on that. What I love about this fleet is how fast they move around the map. Just beautiful. Anyway. This is my Centurion fleet from the Citadel fleet from the actual game.
Centurion.
And what I'll do is after I'll show the build because I forgot to do that. But it's not all that sexual. It needs a few changes on it.
Mm.
It does need a few changes. I've been tinkering with it. I put a build on it initially, then I wanted to change it a little bit because I wasn't particularly too happy with it. Oh, straight off the bat, look at the splash. Right, that's how we know that these Draconian ballistic cannons,
ow,
they are doing about 40 splash as they stand.
Liam, instead of just sitting there, move.
As they stand, they're doing 40 ballistic damage.
Ow.
Look at the Centurion's damage that they took from that lead ship.
They're not Centurions.
Citadels. Sorry, excuse me, guys. I'm
getting carried away. A bit excited, just excuse him.
I'm excited at those new holes, that's for sure.
I think Citadels, you know, they'll actually be quite good.
Oh, these will be good. I tell you where this Citadel fleet will be good is in the new raid. The raid. This fleet's going to mean that I have a very cheap raid and the whole store in April is going to be a fun time for me.
So you can help me.
That's why I built this fleet, for cheap rates.
No, you didn't. You built it to hit bases, but why?
Well, it does hit bases, but I knew that, that this fleet was going to be the best possible fleet in the hostile takeover rates.
Yeah.
Need to move this more forward. That's, I think, that's why these are so good, in fact. This fleet's actually pretty good. Is because of that, such that huge retargeting range on mortars, you can actually run that Punisher so far in front to really avoid any of your other ships collecting the splash from it. And I have two Punishers, and they're both built exactly the same as well, guys. So there's no difference on this fleet. Three Citadels built the same and two Punishers built the same. Originally, when I built this fleet, I actually had the Punisher set up with all countermeasures. And for the raid purposes, I do have another countermeasure Punisher put into my Rhino fleet. Now, what I probably will do in the raid is bring that countermeasure... Punisher back into this fleet when I go to do the raid. But this is alright. This ain't mucking about too much, is it? What we're gonna do now is we're gonna bring them all forward and you send out the other tank. See where we are. Yep, nice stuff. And let's rock. So yeah, this fleet's impressing me actually. I'm very impressed at the moment with this.
He's very impressed with the fleet.
And Lucy is providing the sound effects, which I brought you today by Lucy...
Colander.
Colanderhead.
Yeah, he used to think my surname was Colander.
I like to call you Colander.
Which is quite awkward.
Because you've got a head like a sieve. Oh God, I just amaze myself with these jokes. I really do.
Your jokes are terrible.
I got some good jokes. Recommendations, without any deflection hole. Get one. No, I don't know, actually. I do not know. I don't know if you're even going to be able to try. You will have to hit lower levels. You will have to hit level 30 mines. Unfortunately, yeah, I can't help you there. These are deflection. These are designed around deflection. I can tell you that much. You tell how much for certain that these are designed around deflection. So yeah, you're going to need to get some. I would say that getting D5M onto a hull, like a Jug X, and running that as a tank could work. But you are going to need deflection. But I tell you what, they're not doing too bad. Not doing too bad at all. Yeah, I can't. Do you know what? That wasn't good control on my part, because the mistake I'm making here is that I'm stacking the Punishers because they're so quick compared to the other fleet. So they're getting together. Now that's basically causing them both to take damage when they don't need to. Oh, you cheat! Look at him trying to snipe my fleet. Cheeky little bugger, trying to use ballistic holes against a mortar hole. That's just a weak tactic, White Star.
Was that White Star?
Yeah. This is White Star. Oh, look, are they all waiting around my base or something? You have to bring out these ships and just F with their shit.
Oh, White Star.
White Star, you're going to get it.
I tell White Star to get his Punishers out.
What is it like with normal Rhinos with blades and a Punisher with D10? I don't know. I don't have that available, and I've burnt these coins up so quick that I cannot make that change to try that. This was so here we go. We're looking at this fleet here. This is the new Centurion fleet. I did a level 90 for two coins. This is the Excuse me, I've gotten the wrong ship names as the titles because I rearranged my dock. This is my citadels, and they're doing it for, well, let's just say that's 6 coins because it's 3 hours and 4 minutes. And there was some bad driving there. I think you could get that to 5 coins. I really do. And I think with some tweaks on this, you could get this fleet down to below 30 minutes and repair them for free. This fleet, on the other hand, is dreadful. Absolutely dreadful. Do not bother. Do not bother, because that's too expensive. That was only a level 80. Again, that was only a level 80. That was a level 90. Is there blades on this fleet to try? There is no blades. The only fleet I've got blades on is this fleet, and they'll be no good because they're Kodiaks and they came out 2 years ago. So what else can we try? I'm not sure, but I want to go and hunt that White Star guy.
He's a noob.
He's a bloody noob, that White Star. He'd kick his ass. I don't know how long this test server was open for. I believe it was open for 2 hours, and we are coming up to that now. Right, let's see if this guy. Yeah, he's gonna hurt me. He's gonna hurt me.
Are people sniping you?
He's trying, yeah.
Who is it? White Star?
No, this is someone called Hardcore. But
oh,
come
he's
on.
Hardcore.
He's definitely hardcore, this guy.
Wait, turn. Turn.
Bringing Centurions in.
You're terrible. Whoa.
Holy Centurions!
Dude! Whoa!
That's Judgment Wars. Very, very low arc.
Damn! You got pawned.
Very nice as well. Very nice. I didn't go for Judgment Wars on my fleet. They have lower ship damage. Lower ship damage, but they have much higher building damage. Well, the Pandemonium Mortars have a flat damage across the board, whereas the Judgment Mortars have a flat damage across the board, meaning they do equal damage to ships and equal damage to buildings, whereas the Pandemonium Mortars actually do more damage against buildings but less damage against ships. Although that doesn't take into account if they're shot down. If they're shot down by, say, by countermeasures, then they split into three and their damage is reduced. So, for me, I just looking at the build and the fact that Citadels do the Pandemonium Mortars have 4 shells, whereas the Judgment Mortars only have 2. 32 damage, 32 coins at full damage. That's not a bad repair bill. That is not a bad repair bill at all.
Wilmots and all of you Punishers.
I have Punishers, but I don't have Punishers fully built. My Drake U-base fleet is slightly off whim, so I've only got 2 ships left to build with that, and that's the Drake U-base fleet that in Sector Gadget and myself have been talking about a lot recently. It's one that Gadget's done a video for on our page, and it can do the entire Drake Uranium base, all 4 sections of it, for less than 10 hours total across the fleet. You don't even need to repair the fleet once while doing the base, which is fantastic. I think you can do like each section for 2 hours damage or something. So it's very, very, very good. But I haven't finished that yet. That's actually my fleet I'm currently building, is my Drake U-base fleet. So yeah, I did Citadels first. I couldn't resist.
Citadels. First.
First.
Yeah.
Hi, it's BP time and I'm your host, Liam99.
That's terrible.
I could catch on.
But you're not called BP Time.
No. Good evening, everybody. It's BP Time with me, your host, Liam99.
No.
No?
No. Right. You always start with one, and we're live.
And we're live.
That's what you do every week. You go,
and we're live.
Every week.
Maybe I should shuffle it up. Like, I should just do a different voice.
And we're not live.
Every time it starts the show, I'll do a different voice from now, and I'll be like, hey, we're live.
Hey. No, she'll be like, hey, what you wearing?
What you doing? Stuff.
What kind of stuff?
Things. I can't remember. I think it's from Friends, isn't it?
I've never watched Friends. What?
Just stop saying stuff like that. You will ruin my life. I cannot live with
ruin
someone.
Your life.
I cannot live with someone that hasn't watched Friends.
Friends is shit.
Look, you are coming very close to canceling this engagement. Listen, you can't say that about Friends. That is like my thing. I grew up watching Friends.
Oh, yeah.
I used, whenever I was depressed, I used to watch Friends. It was my favourite program.
Oh,
and you're just there slagging it.
I'm a great co-host. Thank you, Cloppy.
Great co-host. You try playing living with her. Right, let's go. So do you guys, I mean, I don't know if people have come in now that weren't in before or vice versa, but let's get out. Oh, let's go back and do another level 90. How about that?
Yay!
Level 90. Is there anything else I can show you guys while we're here? Bear in mind that I have literally spent 50,000 gold, so I can't do anything that involves coins.
So all
yeah, I'm down to 116 gold. So don't ever let me buy £50,000 worth of gold or 50,000 gold, because that shit can get spent quick.
What have you even done?
I don't even know. I think I'm probably about 20,000 gold's been like me ranking.
That's insane.
Yeah, it's... Oh! Darn it. Someone's already been in here.
Oh.
I'll kill it some more respawn.
Tripper.
Lucy can actually not make a good. No, well, saying that, she can, I think she can make a sandwich. I just rarely see them win.
Hold on, I'm not on comments. What's going on with sandwiches and me?
Rarely do I see a sandwich win. Between the lack of sandwiches and someone not watching Friends.
I just lost chat. That's such a shame.
You lost chat. Well, just go on there. I think I'm logged in as.
You're not
going to
do anything.
I know it's going to be. I've got a message here.
I haven't made you a sandwich in a while, actually. You've been deprived.
Just reading through the comms there, it looks like the server is coming to a roundup now. It looks like everyone's having a chat here and saying thanks for allowing us on the server, etc. So it looks like we are coming to a close, but that's fine. I don't mind that because we've had 2 hours in here. We've been able to really test these holes. We've been able to test these bases. We've been able to try out some older holes in there. We've been able to try out some rhinos and some.
We've even chatted about some movies.
Some citadels. We found out Lucy's absolutely terrible movie knowledge, and the fact that she does not watch Friends, which has gave the relationship serious doubts, I must say. But we can work on that. There's counselling, I guess. There's the Forsaken Council for one. I guess maybe Gadget could sit us in a room and just give us a good talking to.
Oh, really? Oh, really, Liam?
About the relationship.
You're terrible today.
I know.
I don't know what's wrong with you.
Well, I don't know either.
Why'd you do well, then? Here, wait, so you hit in these bases. I'd go straight in. I wouldn't sit outside and rim like you do.
Well, I think rimming is... Oh, God. Rimming is your best option, I think, Lucy. So.
Yeah, I'd go straight in. I just go for it because there's no point in following around and go back in.
Yep. That's true. You would want to go straight in. Straight in. Don't waste time, do you, Lucy?
No, seriously, there's no point rimming it. Just go in. Because you're going to have to come back round and in again.
No, I know, Lucy. But the point of going around the outside and attacking you is... So you take less damage. See, if I go in there, I'm going to be fired upon by this corner, and this torpedo tower. Whereas if I go around the outside and then in, then it's the best way to do it to take the least amount of damage. Okay, now stop making innuendos, please.
You're the one that's doing it, not me.
Yep.
Are you lighting another cigarette?
I need a cigarette living with you, Lucy.
That's like you're 7.
Lucy, I didn't even have any grey hair when I first met you.
That's such a lie. Yes, you did.
I was slim as well.
Of course you were. Yeah. You were slim. Missy.
I was like a young
Oh, look. Missy, keep your paws. Missy. Liam. Look.
What?
Look at the door. Look.
All right, babe. We're on a stream. I don't want to be talking to the cats in the street.
Missy.
Try and get it back on topic because we are getting too silly.
Right, we've got 10 minutes left.
Yes.
What can we do in 10 minutes?
What can we do in 10 minutes? Twice.
Ten times in your case.
Oh, bitch, please.
I guess you're back. Oh,
someone's going to be getting off. Someone's going to be getting a red hand gang.
That gets you back for what you said about me.
No,
today.
No. You've just crossed the line there.
No, I have not. You just got pwned, bitch. Pwned.
Well, I think everyone's having fun hearing our relationship issues. In the chat.
Ten times.
I think maybe even people forgot that we're actually playing BP.
1 minute wonder.
You know what? You're going to give me a bad name. It's bad enough that you don't like Friends. You compared Denzel Washington to Liam Neeson. And you think Frodo turns into Darth Vader. But now you want to say this in public?
See, that takes so much longer. I would have just, you know.
It takes longer, but it's better
there,
because less damage. There's still something to kill.
Oh, you just go along there? Mm. Okay, I thought you had to go right in and round. That's why I was saying.
No, you can drive over that. But I think they can reach it before
that. Yeah,
anyway.
Yeah. That's cool. Mm.
So that's not too bad. Definitely the Centurions, by far, 100%, are the best target for these, are the best hole for these new mines. I'm wondering what else I can test these in. I'll tell you what.
You've only got 8 minutes.
I've only got a few minutes. I think this is going to get cut off in 8 minutes, 11 p.m. my time. But I think we've got time to try out an 85. Let's try out an 85. May as well. So we will. Oh, bloody hell. Let's find another 85. One that isn't partially damaged. Hopefully, I can find an 85 that isn't partially damaged, guys, and we can get in. Egg timer. Thanks, guys. Appreciate the support in chat there.
Egg timer?
Right. We will take a short interval while I strangle Lucy.
Hey.
I shouldn't say that, actually. That sounded terrible. That was
if
a joke.
I die tonight.
That was a joke.
You
but,
know what happened.
But just to let you know, there is an insurance policy. And I am the only person that can collect.
Oh, someone's asking what a cat's called. It's Mitzi.
There's two cats. Every time Lucy mentions a baby, I'll buy her a cat, just so you know. And so far, she's had two cats. So, yeah, that's two bullets dodged. But,
Mitzi.
Yeah, so she's got two cats, Mitzi and Kiki. Very inventive names. Sound like prostitutes, if I'm honest. But, yeah, that's their names, Mitzi and Kiki. One thing we can notice here, guys, straight off the bat, I mean, I did come into this damage, but look at them against ships. Not only are they missing like mad, right? They are missing like mad because their accuracy is low. They are still getting the damage off splash. That's not really affecting it. What you're looking at there is a ridiculously low DPS against ships. Notice that I was killing two ships at once there, even though I was firing at one. And that's because of the splash damage that comes off these cannons. Oh, Jesus. Did you see that? Did you see that? The Hadouken there.
The what? Sorry?
The Hadouken. The Street Fighter Hadouken. Where Ryo shoots the thing. That was what that was. That's why I love these ships. There we go. And there's another one. That is just incredible. Do you know what you need? I think I've just figured something out with these ships.
Right. Someone just compared our cat to a stripper. I'm sorry.
If you intend on using these ships for anything other than these mines, you want to combine weapons that do damage to ships. You want to combine, I would say, maybe the D110s or perhaps R-blasts. Now, if you can figure out a build that will combine the two, so you're getting ship damage as well as that building craziness, then you're going to find that this fleet will probably take most player bases in the game. My opinion. That's my opinion on these. Because these weapons are so low against ships. Such low damage. But against buildings, they're incredible. All you need is one of those little blue waves and boom, game over. One of them on the center island. And that's it. It's gone. The whole island's gone. See that? Just incredible. For anyone that missed the stream, I wanted to see a little bit more about what I did here, what I was messing around with these holes, the build I put on them. All that kind of stuff. If you're interested in knowing what happened in the stream, then by all means, come to our YouTube channel. It won't be on my personal YouTube channel. If you're subscribed to that already, it will be on the show's YouTube channel, which is in our show page. You can search for us on Facebook under TFC. Facebook Groups TFC. That is our name. You will find us. You can search us on YouTube, the Forsaken Council. You can find us on Twitch, where you're watching us right now. You can find me on Facebook and follow me and get all the latest updates there. We may expand to Twitter if the show continues to grow in the way it has done.
Nah, Twitter's rubbish.
So yeah, we're using as much social media as we can. And as many of you know, we've got a show planned tomorrow where we're going to be talking about bass parts.
Woohoo.
And that should be an interesting one. So if you can make that, come out.
Another one, Liam.
That's the same one. And also, we will be. The time that we'll be hosting that is 10 p.m. UK time, which I believe is 2 p.m. PST and 4 p.m. EST. I'm learning these time zones now. I'm getting better. Now, see, if we get a blue wave here, we take out the Wendigo. Do you see that? It's all you need to do.
It's like a lightsaber.
Target the closest turret to you. Just sit and wait.
It's amazing.
Boom.
I missed that strike cruiser though. Did you
see
that?
It wouldn't have been very effective against a strike cruiser, I imagine. Its ship damage will still be low. I don't think it has that buff.
Are you killing an 85 weekly?
I'm trying an 85 weekly here, guys. Yeah, I thought that we may as well just for argument's sake. I mean, I've already tested these out against the mines, and we've seen that the mines are dead easy with this fleet. I took 49 minutes of damage, so I just thought I'd bring them in here.
I'd say the mines are less damaged than what the 85s are.
The mines are, but the reason that is because the mines have no missile damage, they only have ballistic damage and the splash and stuff. I mean, I will be getting fired quite hard from the Wendigos in here. They hurt, so.
I think you killed that Wendigo before I had hit you in there.
On the second one I did, not on the first one. You know, what's great about ballistics in these bases as well, for those that were watching earlier, we've seen that the Draconian coaxial turrets are insane. So missile fleets and mortar fleets are going to be affected badly by that. Whereas this, obviously ballistic cannons can't be shot down. Not at this stage in the game anyway. That's why I think they have an edge there. See, I got three then.
Whoa.
Not that they.
You see a splash in the Kodiaks that hit off it there. That's Amazing.
Yeah, I wouldn't say they're not better than older fleets in the 85 weeklies, that's for sure. I wouldn't go as far to say they're your new go-to fleet for everything, but in those Draconian minds, I can tell you that these are specifically 100% designed for the new mines.
That's asking what the orange.
The orange ring is their friendly field. They have a friendly field. Each ship has it, not just one. All of them. Any ship you build will have it. So I've got four friendly fields affecting all four of the ships. They stack as well. It gives you a 20% reduction in splash damage. So if a mortar lands and it's going to give, like, say it's going to give 1,000 splash damage to every ship there, instead they'll get a 20% reduction per ship equipped. So that's actually 80% splash reduction. That means that mortar will only hit all four of those ships for 200 damage, not 1,000 damage.
That's it, 10 o'clock there.
Yeah, we're at the dead on 10 o'clock mark.
11,
so I can tell you one thing. This 11 o'clock in the UK. This stream will cut out in a minute. Not the stream, the preview server. I was under the impression that this was only going to run for 2 hours, and I've been in here for since it went public. I've been in here for 2 hours, so it will cut out soon. Thank you, Kixi, for allowing the players to get in and test this stuff out, and it was great that you made it public this time around. So props to you for that. I've got a guy waiting on my base to attack me. Crazy Junior, how are you doing? I'll come out and play with you in a second. There we go. That is it. Sorry, excuse me. I've got tons of chats going there. That's it. That's the end of the preview, guys. That is the end of the preview. Again, thank you, Kixi, for allowing us to be involved. Thank you to everyone that come out and watch the stream. Really, really appreciate that. We've had a fantastic stream here tonight. We've had a lot of laughs and a lot of fun. And I will be uploading this video to YouTube now. I'll be uploading it to our YouTube channel. And yeah, thanks everyone. Stay tuned to the show and stay tuned to the chat. And we will see you tomorrow for our open mic night.
Bye.
Bye. All the best. Bye-bye.